Hello, today I'm going to show you how to use a transparent PNG as a texture in cycles. You find a lot of tutorials out there that use two different images to achieve this effect. The first image is mostly a mask, black and white, and the second image is the image itself. I will show you how to achieve the same effect with transparent PNG. First of all, I created a texture in GIMP. You can use every image software you want. I choose GIMP because it has a very nice support for transparent PNG. As you see, we have a checker pattern and with green intransparent fields and a gradient from black to transparent on the background. First of all, I will delete the cube and add a plane on it so we can use this as a floor. I scale it a little bit and I will assign some material, some simple thing, just a blue one or a red one, take whatever you want. Then I add a second plane. So the second plane is will serve us as the object with the texture on it, and also this one gets a material, but not a color, it gets an image texture. So I will assign the texture I created, the one you saw in GIMP. Okay. And to see the result, we switch to the rendered view. Okay, as you see, there is no checker image on it. This is because we haven't unwrapped the texture. So we go to the edit mode, press U, and unwrap it. Now you see the texture, but you also see there that there is no transparency on it. Okay, we are done here. The next things are going to happen in the node editor. So we need some space for it. Here's the node editor. And here we go. First thing is the image texture. The second thing is the standard default diffuse shader and the material output. As we want to achieve some transparency, we need a transparency shader. And we want to mix this both together, so we need a mix shader. Okay, here it is. First of all, we connect the diffuse shader to the lower shader of the mix shader and the transparency shader to the upper shader connector of the mix shader. Then we connect the mix shader to the surface of the output. And here we go. You see that there is a transparent texture on it, but it's still not the texture we wanted to have. There is no gradient on it. This is because the mix shader has no idea where to put the alpha. So therefore, we take the alpha output of the image texture and connect it to the fake input of the mix shader. And here we go. And as you see, there's a very nice gradient transparency on the background. On the background, the dark fields of the checkerboard and the intransparent green fields. Okay, that's all. If you have some questions, some critics, or any comments, please leave them in the section below. Thank you very much, and bye bye.